Why haven't you changed the footer credits on your website yet? Hey guys, Adam back here with another WP Crafter video, and I'm going to show you how to change the footer credits in your WordPress website when your theme developer didn't make it easy to do so. Now, there are before I get into this, have you been to my website lately? I have over 30 videos geared towards people new to WordPress or even people that are experienced with WordPress but don't know every little detail to accomplish what they want. Head over to my website. I've got these videos. They're there. They're available for you. All you got to do is sign up for a free account, and I'm going to give all those videos to you, and it's going to really, really make your website shine and help level up your skills. Anyways, back to this. The footer on your WordPress website, I don't know why all the theme developers don't make it so that it's really easy to change the credits. I just don't get it. But luckily, in this video, I'm going to show you how to change those footer credits to be whatever you want them to be. So let's take a look at my WordPress dashboard. So I've got this theme called Tesseract. I'm going to do it in two themes. I'm going to do it in this theme, and I'm also going to do it in a very popular theme called the Divi theme. Both of them don't make it available. So when you log into the back end of your WordPress website, and let me just clarify what I'm talking about. If I click onto the front end of the website and scroll down, you see right here it says theme by. That's what I'm talking about. Here, let me also open up the Divi theme and show you what I'm talking about there. When you scroll down, it says designed by Elegant Themes, powered by WordPress. So I'm talking about changing those credits to whatever you want them to say. So let's first do it in this Tesseract theme here. You would just go to appearance, and it's the same steps for both, but the code looks a little different. So go to appearance and then click on editor. Now the footer credits are going to be in a file called footer.php. 9 times out of 10, I've never come across a theme that it wasn't in the footer.php. So when you click on that editor, here's the different template files, and we're going to click on the one that says footer. And here it is. It says footer.php. Now, what I like to do, and what I recommend you do, is to highlight everything in here and put it in the clipboard of your on your computer. So what I do is I highlight everything. Now I'm on a Mac, so I do it this way. If you're on a PC, you just hit Control A. It's going to highlight everything, and then I'm going to put it in my clipboard. In case I screw something up, at least I have this in my clipboard and I can easily restore it. But I'm not going to screw anything up. Okay, so hopefully. Okay, so just scroll down to the bottom. So in this particular theme, this Tesseract theme, it's down here. So all you need to do is kind of look for the same text that you see on the front end. So right here it says theme by. So if I go here and I scroll down, I'm looking for where it says theme by. And here it is. Now this is code, okay? There's elements of code in this footer, so you got to be careful what you change, but don't be afraid of breaking something. We just put everything in this file in the clipboard, so you don't have to be like too afraid to break anything. So if you want to change the theme by text, you would just change this right here. Now the remainder of the credit is actually a hyperlink. And so right here is where the hyperlink goes to, and then here's the text that's wrapped around that hyperlink. So you could just change this. So for instance, theme by, we can say I love, and let's say instead of putting this name here, let's say WordPress. And then let's change the link to wordpress.org. Okay, so once you make your changes, just scroll down and click Update File. And I'm going to go here and just do a refresh. And there it is. It's I love, and you can see I've got the hyperlink there for WordPress. So that's how you do it in this theme. Let's do it in the Divi theme. Now I'm just doing this all off the cuff. I haven't looked at it prior to just clicking on the record button, which sometimes could be a mess. But anyways, going to appearance, then editor, and I'm looking for something that says footer. Here it is. And all right, so like I said before, I'm going to highlight it all. I'm going to put it in my clipboard in case I mess something up. And in here, what I'm looking for is where it says designed by, and then there's a hyperlink, and then there's this, I think that's called a pipe, and then it says powered by. So let's see if we can find that. Okay, it's usually at the bottom. Okay, here it is. So it says designed by, so I can change that text. And then here's where it says powered by, and I can change that text. Now here's where I would change the link and the text that went with the link. So here's where the URL goes, and here's where it said premium WordPress theme. I'm sorry, right here where it says elegant themes. And here's the URL to where it has a link to WordPress, and the link to WordPress. So that's pretty much it. It's the same thing. Just click on update file and then do a refresh on the front end and make sure you didn't mess anything up. You can also delete the entire footer if you don't want it. Not the higher footer, I'm talking about the credits of the footer. So let's try to do it on the Divi theme, and I can always restore from what I got in the clipboard. So let's see, I think I would just need to delete this part from the slash P here to the P there. So I'm gonna highlight it all and I'm gonna delete it. And then I'm gonna click on update file. And then I'm gonna go to the front end, click refresh. And you can see the whole credit is gone. So a lot of times you don't need to have a credit, or you might want to put a copyright there. That would be an ideal spot to put a copyright. So now if you messed anything up, remember I have it in the clipboard. So I can go in here and I can highlight everything again like that. And then I can paste what I had in the clipboard, and then I can click on update file. And if I did that right on the front end, when I hit refresh, we should see our credits again. There it is. So that's why I always like to put everything in the clipboard. Well, that's it for this video. Thank you for joining me today on this video. I've got a lot more WordPress videos for you to watch over on my website at WPCrafter.com. Thanks for your time today. And I want to ask you if you could click on the thumbs up of this video and also share it with your friends on your social networks. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next video. Hey, we'd appreciate it if you took a moment to click on the thumbs up button and to share this video with your friends. Also, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and take a moment to go over to our website, leave us a comment, ask us a question, but sign up for our newsletter. Thanks again for watching this video, and make sure you connect with us on these social networks.